Hi everyone, our guest today is Beata Javorcik, the Chief Economist of the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development. The EBRD, as it is known by its acronym, is a London-based development bank that provides financing and technical assistance to emerging Europe and beyond. Beata, who is also a professor in economics at the University of Oxford, is a renowned global expert in the field of innovation and multinational companies, among other pursuits. In her most recent research, Beata and her co-author, Chagatan Birkan and Stefan Pauli, analyze how researchers working for the same companies, but from physically different locations, collaborate with each other. This topic is of great interest to us here at WIPO, as our mission is to promote international cooperation and innovation for the common good. It is also something that many of us are grappling with, as remote work has become more widespread in organizations of all sizes. How can we continue to reap the benefits of people putting their heads together, but remotely? Thank you, Beata, for taking the time to speak to us and sharing your insights. At WIPO, we often take it for granted that the world is better off when innovators from around the world collaborate with each other. Can you remind us why this is the case?
Thank you for having me. The enormous technological progress we witnessed over last decades means that a huge investment is needed to build up knowledge in a single subfield. Gone are the days of people who commanded expertise in multiple disciplines. So collaboration offers access to a greater pool of knowledge. And international collaboration brings also local knowledge to the table. And that may range from expertise in local plants with medicinal use, to understanding what kind of innovation may be suitable for a particular climatic zone. And moving beyond individual projects, international collaboration means transfer of knowledge across international borders. And that may allow less advanced economies to catch up.
Now, the experimental and interactive nature of innovation may lead one to believe that companies centralize all their research and development activities in one location. Why is this not always the case? When do companies disperse their research and development activities to various locations around the globe?
It was true indeed in the 1980s that innovative activity was predominantly located in firm headquarters, or at least in the home country. Progress in tech, in communication costs, lower costs of transportation have meant that now multinationals have spread their innovative activity across the globe. Now, if you consider patents filed after year 2000 by Swiss or Dutch multinationals, it is striking that almost half of them were a result of innovation undertaken in foreign affiliates, with a further third being a result of collaboration between inventors in foreign affiliates and headquarters.
Your study, quite intuitively, shows that international inventor collaboration declines with distance. So French inventors collaborate more frequently with German inventors than they do with Japanese inventors. But independent of distance, your results also show that time zone differences play a particularly large role. Can you elaborate?
In our econometric analysis, we consider business hours overlap between a foreign affiliate and the headquarters of the multinational firm. We find that the higher the business hour overlap, the greater the share of patents in the affiliate that were undertaken in collaboration with inventors at headquarters. And this effect matters beyond distance for which we also control. To give you a sense of magnitude, if you consider a Polish affiliate of a German multinational, this affiliate is 33% more likely to engage in cross-border collaboration than an affiliate located in Japan.
How do you explain your findings? Do smaller overlaps in time zones undermine communication between inventors and ultimately prompt fewer collaborations? Or do innovating companies strategically locate their R&D sites in close-by time zones?
We attribute our findings to communication frictions. Working with people located in a different time zone often requires taking early morning phone calls or having conference calls late in the night. In other words, it is quite inconvenient to work outside of business hours. And that's something that is required when collaborating with people several time zones away. Two results give us confidence that our findings are driven by communication frictions. First, we find that business hours overlap matters more in experimental-based technology classes. These are technology classes that are likely to require more frequent interaction between inventors. And second, we find that episodes of telecom liberalizations, which brought about lower costs of international phone calls, increased cross-border collaboration, particularly for inventors with greater business hours overlap. Now, you asked whether multinationals strategically locate foreign affiliates in nearby town zones. Yes, this could be the case. However, our results are also present if we focus on the sample of foreign affiliates that already existed in the 1980s, that is prior to the major episodes of telecom liberalizations.
Very interesting. Going beyond your study, the COVID-19 pandemic, as you know, forced inventors to collaborate remotely, regardless of whether they were located in the same city, in the same country, or indeed in different countries. Do you think the experience of the pandemic has permanently reshaped inventor collaboration?
The pandemic has permanently changed the way we work, and it has made remote work more acceptable. Thus, I think that it will lead to greater frequency of cross-border collaborations, also when it comes to innovative activity. And this will allow firms to take advantage of the wage differential across countries. So promoting such cross-border collaborations will become irresistible for multinational firms.
Thank you, Beata, for taking the time to speak with us today and sharing your insights. And thank you all for joining us and listening to Beata's perspectives, which offer much food for thought. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to stay informed of other interesting interviews and leave any feedback in the comments section below. Thank you.